he starts reading. He gets an idea, and he goes to the library. He spends hours in the Stouffer Library at Queen's, going through the stacks. Then he'll talk to colleagues, and he'll get an idea, and he'll research it. Particularly in the case of these later pieces I'm talking about, that comes first.
Istvan Anhalt is in the midst of composing The Tents of Abraham. What does he do?
Goes for a walk. Gets away from the piano. And let melodies, harmonies swirl in his head as he walks and imagines structures in terms of notes, chords, rhythms, and come up with a fairly detailed gestalt, structure. And when he arrives back home, if he doesn't want to have a cup of coffee or an apple, he goes up to his room and writes down what he heard while he walked. You know, I go for a walk every day. And after I wrote it down, sometimes I feel, well, why don't I try it on the piano? Did I hear it well or not? It's a wonderful old-timer. It's a 100-plus-year-old Steinway.
Istvan Anhalt doesn't think much of his own piano playing, particularly when facing the undeniable genius of a Glen Gould. After hearing Gould perform a fantasia by Sveilinck, Anhalt was moved to compose a work for him in the same vein. Gould recorded Anhalt's fantasia in July of 1967.
Well, Istvan, as you know, I have a rather high regard for your fantasia, which I recorded a couple of years back for the centennial celebrations. And I'm glad we can play it today.
Speaking of fantasia, from the distance of 15 years, mm-hmm. I'm glad it exists. And
I am too.
It exists especially the way you do it, although I think, tempo-wise, I would have...
What? Are you questioning my judgment, sir? I refuse to be questioned.
Well, you know, anyhow, I respect your interpretation, and I'm speaking about my playing. It probably I would have played a little bit faster. Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's hear my slow interpretation.